Dear students, earlier we were studying risk management. So today onwards we are going to the second part of our subject, that is insurance management. So as I've said, our subject is called risk and insurance management, and I have completed all the details of risk management. So now I'll be going to the topic insurance. So insurance is one of the important topic, and it's a main part, core element of this subject. Therefore, please today onwards learn and give more concentration to the topic insurance. So what is the meaning, what is the definition, and what are the characteristics? So of the insurance that we'll be seeing in today's class. So insurance is a means of protection from financial loss. So in simple, what we say is insurance is a means of protection from financial loss. Any loss that you are going to occur, then why you are going for insurance? To protect yourself from the financial loss that is occurring to you. It is a form of risk management. So we have already studied that in the risk management, one of the tool is insurance. So primarily used to hedge against the risk of a contingent or uncertain loss. So contingent means temporary, and uncertain loss in the future, what is going to happen you don't know. So to protect yourself from the uncertain and contingent losses, so you are taking the insurance. I hope you understand, very simple it is. An entity which provides insurance is known as insurer. So one who gives, now LIC is an insurer. So HDFC gives a life insurance, HDFC life. So it's a insurer. So an insurance company, an insurance carrier, or an underwriter. So this also you have to remember. So insurer is also called as insurance company, insurance carrier, or an underwriter. A person or entity who buys insurance is known as an insured, or as a policy holder, because you are holding a insurance policy, or insured. If you are taking any insurance, you become an insured or a policy holder because you are taking the insurance policy. The insurance transaction involves the insured assuming a guaranteed and known relatively small loss in the form of payment to the insurer in exchange for the insurer's promise to compensate the insured in the event of covered loss. What it says is very simple. An insured will be paying a small amount of the loss that he is going to occur in the future for the sake of getting a protection from the company, one who gives you a guarantee that they will compensate your loss. So I hope you understand, very simple. An insured is giving a small amount of the big loss that he is going to, or he is foreseeing in the future may happen, may or may not happen, it's uncertainty. Why he is giving that certain small amount? Small amount he is giving with the intention that a insurer is guaranteeing him that if he is going to undergo a loss, that he will be compensated. So that is called insurance. The loss may or may not be financial, but it must be reducible to financial terms. So what you call loss sometimes may not be financial. Now life insurance is there. That loss is, if you a person dies, you don't know that, you can't value a person in a terms of the fine money, but a certain compensation is there. So and usually involves something in which the insured has an insurable interest established by ownership. So here is what is there is insurable interest. Regarding insurable interest, we will be studying in the next classes. That's why you don't break your head what is insurable interest. So established by ownership, possession, or a pre-existing relationship. This is what the insurance is. The insured receives a contract called the insurance policy. So when you are making insurance, is a contract between the insured and the insurer, and insurance insurer gives you an insurance policy which details the conditions and circumstances under which the insurer will compensate the insured. So it give you all the details. If you have seen any insurance policies, all the details are written down. What are the conditions and what are the circumstances you will be compensated. The amount of money charged by the insurer to the policyholder for the coverage set forth in the insurance policy is called the premium. So you are aware of another term, premium. Premium is the amount that is fixed by the insurer that you are paying, not only once, it may be on the installments. So this is regarding the insurance. So you have seen different terms in the insurance, what insurance is, then you know who is insurer, who is policyholder, who is insured, what is premium, what is insurance contract. So let's move towards the another slide. So that is the definitions of insurance. So not only one definition, I have given many definitions. You can take or you can make it as you want. So insurance may be defined as a consisting one party, the insurer, agrees to pay to the other party, the insurer or his beneficiary, a certain sum upon a given contingency against which insurance is sought. So here one party, the insurer, is agreeing to pay to the other party, that is to the insured, not only to the other party, it sometimes may be to his beneficiary. And in case of the life insurances, usually if the person is dead, it is to the beneficiary or nominee whom you are given, a certain sum upon a given contingency for which to a particular loss. So in the life insurances, they make it okay for this. So in the vehicle insurances, for this. So different insurances have a different reasons for that. So then against which insurance is sought, for which purpose you have taken, only for that. Now you have taken a car insurance and you can't say that your other items are damaged because of car accident. So it is only for the car. So Commission on Insurance Terminology of the American Risk and Insurance Association has defined insurance as follows. This is a one board given a definition. We'll see. Insurance is the pooling of fortuitous losses by transfer of such risks to insurers who agree to indemnify insureds for such losses to provide other pecuniary benefits on their occurrence or to render services connected with the risk. So here some words meaning you must see. Fortuitous. Fortuitous means this one. Occurrence. So chance. So unfortunately it happened, like that we say. So by chance. So insurance is the pooling of fortuitous losses, unfortunate losses. So you don't know, you're not sure losses. By transfer of such risks to insurers. So you are transferring your risk, that losses you're going to happen, to the insurer who agree to indemnify, that is means to compensate. So indemnify insureds for such losses to provide other pecuniary benefits. Pecuniary means financial. So remember that pecuniary means not only money, like financial benefit. Sometimes whatever damage they correct and give you, it involves the money. So benefits of on their occurrence or to render services connected with the risk. So sometimes services connected. Now what happens is health insurance. So they are giving you a service sometimes. So all this. Now you are making a insurance with the particular hospital itself. Hospital cards are there. So they are not paying you money, but they are, if you are becoming sick, they will give you a service. This is what the information regarding the insurance definition. So we have another two angles of definition that we'll see. So the definition of insurance can be made from two points. So that is a functional definition and a contractual definition, because insurance is a contract. Another is insurance is a function. So there are various functions of definition, functions of insurance. On the basis of functions, we'll see. Insurance is a cooperative device to spread the loss caused by a particular risk over a number of persons
who are exposed to it and who agree to insure themselves against the risk. So insurance is a cooperative device. Cooperative means many people join together to spread device, to spread the loss caused by the particular risk over a number of persons. So many people are of the same nature. Now all two-wheelers make a insurance, so they have all the risk of facing the damage to the two-wheeler. So who are exposed to it and who agree to insure themselves against the risk. So they are exposed to the risk and all who are agree to insure themselves. Sometimes people are not agree to insure themselves. So only sometimes they are. Now health, see, people all are prone to become a sick, but all are not making the health insurance. So it is a what you call only who agree to insure themselves. Now on this definition, basis of this definition, so what insurance is? So a cooperative device to spread the risk. What is it says is you are spreading the risk to many people. Actual risk is pooled together. Then the system to spread the risk over a number of persons who are insured against the risk. So it is on number of persons insured against the risk. Spreading way. Spreading on the number of persons who are insured against the risk. Then the principle to share the loss of each member of the society on the basis of probability of the loss to their risk. And finally it says the method to provide security against losses to the insured. These are the functions of insurance, we can say. So in the next classes we will be dealing with that. So the method to provide security against losses to the insured. So similarly another definition can be given. Insurance is a cooperative device of distributing losses falling on an individual or his family over a large number of persons, each bearing a nominal expenditure and feeling secure against heavy losses. So this is another definition of functional definition of insurance. I hope you understood. This depends on basis of what are the functions. Functions are, one is a cooperative device, spreading the risk, then gathering the number of persons there, then sharing the losses among the persons who are insured, then security against the loss of the insured, means you are going to compensate. So this is what the definition of functional definition of insurance. So we have another definition, that is a contractual definition. So insurance has been defined to be that in which a sum of money as a premium is paid in consideration of the insurers incurring the risk of paying a large sum upon a given contingency. So insurance has been defined to be that in which a sum of money as a premium, so some money, portion of your loss is to be paid in consideration of insurance incurring the risk of paying a large sum upon a given contingency. If the problem takes place, damage takes place, then he will be giving you a large amount. So now you are giving a small amount. From where he is giving you a large amount? Because he is gathering the amount from the many persons. So pooling of the risk, this is. So the insurance thus is a contract whereby certain sum called premium is charged in consideration. So here, based on the contract, you are making a contract, and on the contract what you are paying? Certain amount is paid. Then against the said consideration, a large sum is guaranteed to be paid by the insurer who received the premium. Why you are paying a certain amount? Because you are sure that the insurer is going to give you a large amount when the loss takes place. The payment will be made in a certain definite sum, that is the loss of a policy, the loss or the policy amount, whichever may be. So sometimes a policy amount only, sometimes a large amount, depends on agreement, and it's a agreement, it's a contract made that a certain definite sum will be paid. The payment is made only upon contingency. Say payment is made when according to the agreement what the loss takes place.
So I hope you understand what the definition is. So now you have seen the meaning, what insurance is and what are the definitions, and on the definitions also you have two bases, that is one is contractual definition, another is you have seen the functional definition. So based on this you have understood now what the concept is. And next we have the characteristics of insurance. I am not going to explain in today's class because it will take much time. So there are so many characteristics if you go to the Google and all. So I am not going to explain or take it all the characteristics of insurance, but basic and very important characteristic of insurances, these are the only four, but there are so many insurances. This characteristics all depend on, one is pooling of the risks, payment of fortuitous losses, risk transfer and indemnification. So these are the characteristics, main characteristics of the insurance, that I'll be explaining in the next classes. So this is one of the important topic and very important from the point of the examination of point of view, insurance, definition of insurance, characteristics of insurance. So after that we'll be going with the insurable interest, then functions of insurance, so all the, then principles of insurance, so all these aspects connected with the insurance will be gone dealing. Thank you.